Hi friends, today we can see about compensator in control system. This is one of the important part in the control system, and in any competitive examination at least one question will be in from this part. Okay, and this is very important part and very easy also. Okay, first of all we can see about what is a compensator. Compensator is nothing but additional device that is added to a control system to obtain the performance as per desired specification. Okay, in a control system we are adding some additional devices for what? For performing, to obtain the some performance. Okay, as per our desired specification we need to obtain some performance. For that we are adding some additional device to the control system. This is termed as a compensator. Okay, there are two types of compensator, which is lead and lag. Okay, phase lead compensation and phase lag compensation. First of all we can see about phase lead compensator. Okay, in phase lead compensator there will be a resistor in parallel with the capacitor. Okay, and this combination is series to a resistor. This is termed as a phase lead combination. There will be a resistor parallel with the capacitor. Okay, and then a resistor which is in series. Okay, resistor which is in series, and the combination of these two is said to be a phase lead compensation. Okay, then the required output V naught of S by VI of S. V naught of S is nothing but output V naught of S by VI of S is equal to alpha into 1 plus ST by 1 plus S alpha T. Okay, this is the required output equation for the phase lead compensator. In this alpha is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, and T is equal to R1C. Okay, these two are important formulas. Okay, alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 and then T is equal to R1C. Okay, then we can see about the pole zero configurations of phase lead compensator. This is a very very important concept for phase lead. This is the real imaginary axis, this is the real part. The pole zero configuration will be zero will be near to the origin and then pole will be apart next to the zero. Okay, this is the pole zero concept, and this we will be considering zero as minus 1 by T and then pole as minus 1 by alpha T. Okay, 0 as 1 by T, minus 1 by T, and pole as minus 1 by T. Okay, and these two combinations said to be a pole zero concept. Okay, this representation is very very important because many questions are framed relating to this concept. Okay, in this omega is equal to 1 by T and omega is equal to 1 by alpha T. Okay, then we have to see about the very very important, which is the phase angle. Okay, phase angle is nothing but tan psi m is equal to 1 minus alpha by 2 root alpha. Okay, this is nothing but the tan psi m, and then sin psi m is given by 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. Okay, this is the sin psi m value. Okay, actually from these two we may be able to find the phase angle. Actually by finding the using this formula, the both the formula, by using both the formulas we get the same answer only. Okay, and in many questions are framed related to this phase angle because in the gate question also they repeatedly asking problems based on the phase angle. So we need to know that this is a simple formula and we should be familiar with that. Okay, phase angle. Then we can see about the properties of a phase lead compensator. First of all, shift gain crossover frequency to a higher value. It shift the gain crossover frequency to the higher value. Okay, speed of the noise response can be improved. Then speed of response can be improved. Steady state error not that much improvement. Okay, in this phase lead steady state error is not improved to that extent. Okay, and then time constant is decreased. Time constant value is decreased. Okay, the first important property is that gain crossover frequency to a shifts gain crossover frequency to a higher value, then speed of the response is improved, then steady state error is not that much improvement. There will not be any improvement in steady state error. That is the point the community say. There will not be any steady state improvement. Time constant is decreased. Okay, these are the properties of a phase lead compensator. Then we can see about the phase lag compensation. We have seen that in lead the resistor will be parallel, in resistor will be capacitor parallel to resistor. This combination to be phase lead compensation. Okay, but phase lag is nothing but a resistor will be parallel to the resistor will be parallel to the what? Capacitor. Okay, this combination to be phase lag compensator. Okay, then as per phase lead, phase lag also have output equation, which can be V naught of S by VIF S is equal to 1 plus ST by 1 plus S beta T. Okay, here in that beta is equal to R1 plus R2 by R2. Okay, and then T is equal to what? T is equal to R2C. Okay, this is the phase lag compensation. Okay, then very very important, we need to know the pole zero configuration. Okay, in this the pole zero concept of phase lag, this is the real imaginary part, this is the real part, this is the real part, and this is the imaginary part. Okay, here pole zero is nothing, this is pole will be very very near to the origin and zero will be nearer to that pole, and then the pole can be given by the what? 1 minus 1 by beta t. Okay, and then 0 will be minus 1 by t. Okay, we need to note that this first one is nearer to the origin, minus 1 by beta t, and next to that 0 is minus 1 by t. Okay, in this we may write omega is equal to 1 by t, and omega is equal to 1 by beta t. Tan psi m is equal to 1 minus beta by 2 root beta, sin psi m is equal to 1 minus beta by 1 plus beta. Okay, tan psi m is equal to 1 minus beta by 2 root beta, sin psi m is equal to 1 minus beta by 1 plus beta. Okay, we can see some of the properties related to phase lag compensator. Bandwidth is reduced, first one. Then improvement in steady state error. In the phase lead, there will not be that much improvement in steady state error, but in the case of phase lag compensation, there will be improvement in steady state error. Okay, okay. Then speed of the response is reduced, and then time constant increases. Okay, these are the properties of phase lag compensation. Okay, it's very very important. Each and every formula is very important. There will be many one more questions are usually framed from this concept, and the property also important, which is speed increases and in which speed decreases. They'll be asking in that assertion questions or choose the correct statement like that. So this is very very important. Okay, we can see some other problems related to phase lead and lag in the next video. Thank you.